Okay, so I'm gonna start showing everyone how to make the face like I did on this guy. It's a little different than I would have thought it would have been because it's when I first started doing it, I was making a mask, and it's hard to transition from a mask to a head because a mask is flat. So I found it's better to just go ahead and think of it as a whole head, like from your jaw up to your face instead of just your face, and then making the head. It's hard to explain, but I'll try to show you as I go. This is just it so far. I'm gonna try to make the horse neck transition into his torso right there. And I don't know. From far away it looks really cool, but if you get close, you can see it's just a bunch of simple shapes all welded together. Here's one of the first masks I made. It's in my scrap pile, but this was really simple to make. I don't even know why I'm showing. It's kind of ridiculous now. Right. Okay, so the first thing I showed you was an actual head, a whole head, and the second thing I showed you was just a mask. And the mask is just pretty much just two-dimensional, just pretty much this part. And that's real easy to make. I mean, it's just like that torso I made, except for there's different bumps. But if you want to make an entire head, I discovered this little method here. And if anyone out there has any ideas, I mean, please tell me, because it's really the first head I ever made, and I kind of was going along or making it up as I go along. But I would like to take any suggestions if you all have it. But first of all, I like to start off with a template like I was showing you with paper. And what I discovered is, instead of just doing like the mouth part or whatever, go ahead and do it to where you're like the middle part of the eyes. And kind of measure it around to your ears. See, it'll be that big. Okay. And then I'll go ahead and fold it in half right there. And that's the center. I'll go ahead and mark. And then the chin is about right there. And you can just draw it like going like that. And then you can just draw it going like this. And then I'll just stick it right here. Okay. Hold on one second. Okay, so here I have it about where I want it. And I have it folded in half so I can just cut it on this one line. It'll be symmetrical. Okay, so that's about right. I could cut a little bit more down here, but I can do that later, or I could forge it over as I go. But that's about the shape you want for the bottom part of your face, or whatever space you're making. It looks a little big, but once you bend it over, you know, that's what you want. And I want it at the eye level, because instead of cutting holes for the eyes, I'm gonna heat it up and bang it in so it'll look like it's denting in. I'll show you when I get there. Okay, so I have my template here. I just put it on the metal, trace it, and then cut it. Okay, so here's the piece cut out as per my template here. And what I want to do is mark some lines that are symmetrical down the
down the middle of it. So I'll just get my little piece of paper and just give it a couple of folds. It doesn't really matter where, as long as it's folded in half so they're in the same place when you open it. And then open it up. And each one of these creases, I'm going to transfer that line to the metal part so I can have a little grid to go when I'm bending it so that I can keep it symmetrical. Okay, so I put some lines perfectly symmetrical on both sides. And then I'm going to hammer this piece of metal until it curves and it fits like a face. And I guess I can show you that part. Okay, when I first made that face, or the head for that metal man, I didn't have a horn. But now I kind of have like an improvised horn. But the way I did it the first time was I just got a cross peen hammer and kind of hit it like this while I was pulling it up and shaped it like that. And it worked out really good, so I'm going to do it that way. Or I can use that little horn that I made over there. Let me just show you what I mean. As you can see, it's starting to curve, and I use the lines to kind of go on those, and I just want to use that until it's curved all the way around. It doesn't take very long, but just keep doing that until it's the shape you want. Just do a little of one side and then a little of the other side. You don't want to start curving too much or you'll never get it symmetrical. Or maybe you will, I don't know. It just seems safer this way. Okay, so as you can see, it's starting to take shape. And what I did was I first hit along the solid lines on all the way down, and then I hit in the middle of the lines all the way down to keep it symmetrical. And when you're hitting it against the anvil, hold on. Okay, when you're hitting it against the anvil, you don't want to hit it exactly where the anvil's touching. You want to hit it where it's kind of sticking up a little bit. That way it'll have room to fold. So if you just hit it directly on it, it won't move at all. But if you hit it a little bit where it's coming off the anvil, then it'll have room to fold over like it's doing there. And I'm just going to keep doing this until I got it the way I want it. I don't think you need to see the rest of it.